Now chapter 2, exercise 2.3 of class 9 math is about remainder theorem. Remainder theorem states that when fx is divided by gx, then remainder Rx is fx
divisor
is x plus y. Here g of c is x plus y. From here x is equal to minus y. By taking x plus y is 0 and y on the right side. So the remainder will be f minus y. So in place of x, put minus y. So minus y equal to plus 3 into minus y. One square plus 3 into minus 5 and plus 1. So it becomes minus 5 plus 3 into positive. So 3y square minus 3y into y plus minus 1 minus 10 plus 1. So this will be written in fourth part. One more part is left you to your own. Then question number 2. Question number 2 is here f x is question 2. Same thing is x x is x cube minus 6 square plus 6 x minus 8 and 0. The divisor is x minus a by which x is equal to a. Therefore, the remainder here will be f a, which in place of x a will be 2. So it is a cube minus a into a square minus 6 into a minus a. So it becomes a cube minus a cube minus 7 a. And that is cancel. So minus 7 a will be the remainder. Now it includes factor theorem, which specifies that whenever f x is factor of, whenever g x is factor of f x, then g x should be such that remainder should be 0. Means whenever remainder is 0, then g x is factor of f x. And in part 3 it says, check whether this is divisible by this, divisible by this one. Means 7 plus 3 x, you have to check that whether 7 plus 3 x is a factor of 3x cube plus 7x. So in place of x, you will put x is equal to by 3 is 0 minus 7 by 3. 7 plus 3x is equal to 0. 3x is equal to minus 7, which implies x is equal to minus 7 by 3. So here the remainder comes 3 into minus 7 by 3 cube plus 7 into minus 7 by 3, which becomes 3 into 3, 7 cube means it will be minus here. 7 into 7 into 7 is 3 over 3. Upon 3 cube is 27, that works by 9. Minus 7 into 7 that is 49 by 3. It is minus 3 4 by 3 4 3 by 9 minus 49 by 3. Obviously, this is not equal to 0. So, 3, 7 plus 3x is not a factor of 3x cube plus 7x. This is about remainder and factor theorem. It is from NCERT. You do sums from R.S. Agarwal book on remainder theorem and factor theorem. If any problem arises, you ask with me. I share the
computer system for some.
In question number 1 of exercise 2.4, question number 1.1, it says check whether x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So by rule, x plus 1 is divisor and this is dividend. If the matter is 0, then it will be a factor. So by this x is equal to minus 1, if you put it 0, x becomes minus 1. Put minus 1 here to get the remainder. So minus 1 cube plus minus 1 square plus minus 1 plus 1, which gives minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1, which is 0. Because when this will be divided by this expression, the remainder will be 0, therefore it will be a factor of. Here remainder is 0, therefore x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Is it factor? Similarly, 3 more things are given. You can check them. I did first, second is similar, third is similar. So, for your practice, I am giving 4th one. In 4th one, same, x plus 1 is divided, so x is equal to minus 1, and the expression is x cube minus x square minus 2 plus root 2 into x plus root 2. Why? It is f x. So f minus 1 will be minus 1 cube minus minus 1 square minus 2 plus root 2 into minus 1. So it becomes, it is minus 1, it is minus 1, it is minus 1, so it becomes plus 2 minus 1, 2, it will be plus, the same thing, it is plus, and plus 1, so because by putting x is equal to minus 1, these 2 quit. But these 2 add and becomes 2 root 2. So it is not a factor of this. If here is minus, then it can be. If this is minus, this will be minus, then it will become 0. And then this will be a factor of the given expression. In this way, we have discussed again this common rule for factor theorem. Use factor theorem to determine whether gx is a factor of. Same thing is in given question number 2. So let us do question number 2 here, and then proceed. I am doing any one part of question number 2 because now you are familiar with the rule of factor theorem. So I am doing second part of question 2. Second part, 3 parts are given to you. Do your homework. X cube plus 3x square So we discussed here these two sums on Pythagoras theorem. Now it is about 16 minutes video. So let us stop over here and we shall discuss later on further about other questions of exercise 2.4.